I'm dentist in Korea, Dr. Don. Today I want to share about Lee-Kiss analysis. Lee-Kiss, he graduated from dental school at Indiana University in 1943. This is Indiana. And he go to University of Illinois under Dr. Brody in 1947 to study orthodontics. Dr. Brody was a student of Engel, who is the father of modern orthodontics. And Dr. Lee-Kiss got master's degree from University of Illinois Graduate School of Orthodontics in 1950. Dr. Brody was a chief of orthodontics, and he majored in another major, anatomy. So his student, I think his student, there's a Downs, who is famous for Downs analysis, and the Downs was a student of Brody, and Brody majored in anatomy. So his students were deeply involved in anatomy, I think, and his students, the Downs, Lee-Kiss, was famous for cephalometric analysis. Okay. Lee-Kiss showed four C's. The one C is characterize or describe the existing conditions. The second C, compare on individual with another or the same individual with himself at a later time. And third C, classify certain descriptions into various categories. The fourth C, communicate all these aspects to the clinician, to a fellow research worker, or to a patient. I agreed on that points. And someone says a cephalometric analysis is not important. He says the clinical review and clinical analysis is more important. At some point it is right, but the forces which Dr. Lee-Kiss emphasized was important. In my opinion, when I study orthodontics, the with cephalometric analysis background, I usefully I get information, useful information about the patient. Dr. Lee-Kiss wrote an article many times. In 1981, he wrote an article about treatment planning and estimating growth. It is very special point, the estimating growth, and other cephalometric analysis does not comment about growth, but Lee-Kiss comments the growth. This article is Lee-Kiss article in 1981 in the Engel Orthodontist. This figure shows the age change. In Lee-Kiss analysis, there are special landmark, very characteristic landmark in Lee-Kiss analysis. The pit point is one of them. The pit point is the junction of telemaxillary fissure and the foramen rotundum. This is pit point. It is the superior and posterior point of telemaxillary fissure. It is the junction of telemaxillary fissure and foramen rotundum. Foramen rotundum is located on this side. The lower part of foramen rotundum and the telemaxillary fissure meet in this point. This is PT point. And CC point is the center of cranium. This is the point of intersection of the Bayesian-Naegean plane and the facial axis. This is facial axis, the Naegean. PT from PT point and Naegean and Bayesian-Naegean plane, and the intersection point is the CC point. This is CC point. And Xi point is the geometric center of the ramus. Xi point is formed like this. And we can draw a pterygoid vertical. From FH plane, and the most posterior surface of the pterygoid maxillary fissure, we draw a tangential line to the pterygoid maxillary fissure, the posterior wall of pterygoid maxillary fissure, and the right angle from the FH plane. This is pterygoid vertical, PTV. And parallel to pterygoid vertical, we can draw a line, the deepest, we can point the deepest point of anterior wall of ramus. This is R1 point. We draw a R1 line to pass to R1 point. And we can draw a line, the parallel line to R1, and the direct opposite to R1, we can point R2, and we can draw a parallel line, and then we can point R3. R3 is the deepest portion of the sigmoid notch. And we can draw a line to right angle from the R1 line. And just under the light R3, we can point R4. And the same way, we can draw a line through the R4. And we can make Xi point. We can the cross line, and we can get Xi point. Okay, this is Xi point. This is geometric center of the ramus. And DC point is the center of condylar neck along the Bayesian-Naegean line. This is DC point. And PM is the, this is PM point. This is the point which the symphysis mentalis changes from convex to concave. This is PM point. And it is about the center of B point and pogonion. And PTV is point of intersection of the distal outline of the PTM fissure and perpendicular to the FH plane. This is pterygoid vertical, PTV. And in Ricketts analysis, we can think about polar growth phenomenon. It is the theory the facial growth radiate from the foramen rotundum to outwardly. Anatomically, through the foramen rotundum, the nerve go through foramen rotundum and outwardly and radiate outwardly from foramen rotundum. So the polar growth theory says the growth radiate from foramen rotundum outwardly. It is polar growth phenomenon. So the Likas thought the PT in the center, from the center of PT point, the growth radiates outwardly. So he named this line in facial axis, the growth axis, growth direction axis. And this is the point and plane in Likas analysis. We previously said PTV and DC point, R1, R2, R3, R4, and Xi point, and mandibular plane, and facial axis. And this is Antponian line's facial plane. Okay. And through this angle, the Dr. Likas says about the facial height, and it shows open bite or deep bite tendency. Okay, this is the outline of Likas analysis. And in detail, from now on, in detail, I want to say about landmark and the value, cephalometric value. And facial axis, the facial axis is the angle between Bayesian-Naegean, this Bayesian-Naegean line plane, and foramen rotundum, and to Naegean. This is the facial axis. It shows face height, and it is it prognoses the direction of growth of the face. The normal value in 9 years old in right angle 90 degrees, the normal value, and in brachyfacial type. In black one is the more the greater facial axis angle, and the dolichal facial, the long face, less angle. And facial angle okay, facial angle or facial depths and okay, FH plane an Nation Pogonian plane. It is a facial angle. It shows horizontal position of the chin. So it shows skeletal class 2 or class 3 pattern. The normal value in 9 years old and 87 degrees. It increases 1 degree every 3 years. So in adult, it is for the facial angle. The facial depth is about 90 degrees. It is very important to understand the facial pattern. And mandibular plane angle. The mandibular plane angle is the angle between FH plane and the gonion, nation plane. It is about 26 degrees. It decreases 1 degree every 3 years. And mandibular arc, it shows mandibular band. It is the angulation of the condylar process to the body of the mandible. It is the mandibular arc. It is the normal value is about 26 degrees, and at 9 years old, and 3 degrees increase in every 5 years. Facial convexity. This is a direct measurement of point A to the facial plane. This is facial plane, and this is A point. The distance shows facial convexity. It is a useful description of contour of the bony profile. The normal value is 2 millimeters at 9 years old, and it decreases 1 millimeter every 3 years, gradually decreased to a 0 millimeter at the adulthood. The palatal plane to FH plane, it is 0 degree. This is palatal plane, and this is palatal plane and FH plane. Okay. And denture height, it shows raw facial height. This is angle made by ANS and Xi point and PM. And the normal value is 47 degrees. It shows tendency of open bite or deep bite. And lower incisor position and angulation. And I think it is very important, lower incisor to apogonion line. The 1 millimeter ahead of the apogonion line. It is the normal value. And it is very, very, very important, I think. And upper molar to PTV. The pterygoid vertical to the distal of the upper molar. The normal value is the patient age plus 3 millimeters. It is what does it mean? If the malocclusion is due to the upper or lower molar, it shows. And deciding whether extractions are necessary or not, and there's enough room for the molar and the large upper molar to PTV shows there's a room for the expansion and distalization of the molar. Interincisor angle. And Likas did not agree with Down's norm of 135 degrees, as he said that the same sample were chosen with bias. So he suggested a lower angle. It is 125 or 126. In this condition, good articulation and smooth incisor guidance. It is very famous aesthetic plane in Likert's analysis. The E-plane, we call it E-plane. The tip of the nose to the soft tissue progonium. It is the Likert's E-line. In adulthood, the lips should be contained within the nose chin line for aesthetic purposes. It is very aesthetic appearance. The lower lip range from plus 2 millimeters to minus 2 millimeters from the E line. And an average is minus 2 millimeters at 9 years old. So it is a summary of Likert's analysis. Facial axis, the facial axis shows the growth direction. It is about 90 degrees. It does not change with age. And so the greater facial axis means brachycephalic face, and the less facial axis means the narrow and long face, the dolichocephalic. And two, facial angle or facial depths, it is the FH plane and the facial plane. This is the facial depths angle, and it is about 87 degrees, but it changes plus 1 degree every 3 years. So adulthood, the facial depths and facial angle is about right angle. And mandibular plane angle is between FH plane and gonion nation plane, and about 26 degree, but it changes like this, about minus 1 degrees every 3 years. And okay. And lower facial height, and it is the ANS and Xi point and PM, and about 47 degrees, no change with age. And mandibular arc also change, but the mandibular arc and mandibular plane is similar, so I think it is only think about mandibular plane angle. Okay, and convexity. Convexity of point A is 2 millimeters, and it changes minus 1 millimeter every 3 years. So in adulthood, to FH plane and nasion pogonion plane, it is facial plane and right angle, and it meets an A point and pogonion. It is one lineup. And lower incisor to A pogonion is very important, and 1 millimeter and nor change with age. And lower lip to lip line, E plane, and we call it Likas E line, the minus 2 millimeter, less protrusive with growth. Okay, we reviewed recast analysis. So maybe we cannot memorize the exact value, number, angle, but we can understand the growth pattern and the average face and average aesthetic face. What is average aesthetic face? And through recast analysis, we can understand the overview. And average face and aesthetic face, the FH plane is similar to parallel to palatal plane and about 0 degrees and 9 degrees and occlusal plane, and mandibular plane is 26 degrees at age of 9 and reduce with age about 23. Okay, it is the overview. And anterior posteriorly, it is very important. Facial angle and nasion, pogonion line and FH plane is about right angle 90 degrees, and A point is positioned forwardly at age 9, but it lines up in adulthood and pogonion line. So in adulthood, nasion, A point, pogonion is in positioned in one line. Okay, this is overview. And soft tissue profile, and if we draw the nose tip and pogonion, and the lip is should be positioned posteriorly aesthetically, and about 2 millimeters in lower lip and 2 millimeters. It is the summary of Ricker's analysis. Okay, thank you.